Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Yeah. Welcome to tonight's meeting with the Eastwood Hotel Council Planning Committee. I'd like to declare the meeting open. We've got a new gavel, much heavier than the old moderator. Here he is. So we've got a lot of members of the public in today on one application. The first item on our agenda is public participation. I believe there are two people who wish to speak. As I said, we're going to get 2 minutes. Once we get 10 seconds left, I will raise my hand. Okay. So you can find amongst yourselves who would go first. You could stand up and just say your name and what application you're talking about. And then we can start. So, who would like to go first?
Good evening, everyone. I'm Danny Mark and I'm in Stanley Way. I'm here to strongly object to the planning application at Stanley Way, which is to build a 3-bedroom bungalow and is essentially a garden. But this plot is totally in self environment because my father and my neighbours believe this would be a huge home development. We at Stanley are in a small enclave of historic building. It's a peaceful, tranquil setting in the world, which will be guided by the introduction of a new building. And keeping the standard building and aesthetic of future generations forever. I'd like to bring to the attention of the planning committee some of the information provided is inaccurate. The architect's macro site analysis is incorrect. It states the plot has separate access via the track off Cranston Road. There is no access to that track on Cranston Road. The proposed access is my driveway that only leads to my property, which I have maintained as access for over 23 years. As the previous owner for that same period of time. However, there are two entrances to Stanley Way, College Lane and Sand Lane. All three access points are not particularly suitable for heavy vehicles, which would be required for such a place. Consultation report from Highlands is not accurate either. Paragraph 2 states existing vehicular access is shared with several other residential properties. This is not correct. There is only one property in the Highlands, which is Stanley Way. I believe that error might be because I haven't actually done a site visit, but just done a density. And I pointed this out to Captain and Fox. The proposed build would impact adversely on my items and my neighbours, especially if we're looking for building. The noise and disruption of this project would cause huge disturbance on a daily basis and much distress to us in our retirement. Furthermore, if this project were to go ahead, it would cause problems not only for us accessing our own property at times, but also our children and visitors. We say that this area is a haven for birds and wildlife, schools, and birds. We all enjoy in this unique setting. This would all be disrupted while building was going on, further reducing their habitat by the disruption and the introduction of the fusion of build for all the different towns. Thank you.
Thank you. Yeah, my name is Michael Ashdown. I live at the Cube, situated on the west side of the Fox and the West. I'm very much opposed to the development of the following weeks. The proposed access. No vehicle right of way exists to this new plot over the whole private plot. There is, in fact, no vehicle access to it, only pedestrian gate. The private track is too narrow, 2.6 metres for commercial vehicles. The track runs along my eastern boundary, on which my substantially built sign. And I have seen even medium-sized vans cannot pass by the side, so somehow which is almost on the boundary. Anything bigger is likely to cause substantial damage to my boundary fence and sign. Two, it is seriously overbearing and will result in loss of life. My property and also building, both bungalows, sit at a level at least 5 feet below the proposed building. Looking at our properties from the proposed building site, when in fact that looks down on our roof, clearly it will tower over our properties, blocking our outlook and light on the south. In particular, the light to our living room, at a quick, in particular, the light. A living room that is human. The plan shows the property 2 metres from the boundary and cast a shadow over both properties. 3. Flood risk. At times of heavy rain, roof escapes from the proposed site and down. In the case of building, land drainage was carried out a few years ago. On my plot, the ground is unable to retreat to water and the excess results in flooding to my plot. We are very concerned that development will exacerbate. In conclusion, I believe this site has to be viewed in person to appreciate the problems and my concern. My final proposal, as submitted, is leaving and inaccurate. It's highly detrimental to the natural environment and amenity existing residents, and as such, I ask that permission be declined.
There are. Thank you, everyone. Item number two is apologies. We can allow item three is received in minutes of the meeting held on the 6th of March. I'd like to propose these, please. We'll have a second. Are there any more questions in those minutes? Item number four is to receive the members' declarations of interest. Are there any new ones that you want noted?
Just declare interest on item seven. I do sit on the licensing committee.
Item five is chairman's announcements. Lightly on this one, please can you note here that we are now in the election. To inform committee that SA19 application has come forward, the district did ask the developer to hold this until after the election. For the reason for that debate, which is if any candidate standing in the room tonight, and not to make any comment in the way that this is determining itself. Item number six is the NPPF consultation response. This is to note the submission as a delegated position by dedicated decision by the clerk and consultation with the vice chair and faculty. It's been circulated for a minute. People are not saying huge thank you to both our councillors. Item number seven is licensing applications. There is only one licensing.
Can I just go back? We didn't know that officially, just for my sake.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Item number seven is licensing applications. There is only one application tonight. Normally refer these to be not discussing. Are there any comments made on that? Item number eight is the meeting. We are going to start with DM23-0335. This is 14 railway approach. This is change of use of first floor existing mixed-use building from office class B to residential.
version of the third and second floor to provide self-contained rooms and landscape terrace, first floor level, pedestrian and vehicle access. Ground floor will remain in office use. So finally, so that's it was fun on you, I think. So this is this is existing. Mainly in tunnels. There is one comment on the portal from disability access, and so the proposed design does not address the access issues for those that are disabled. This is town, so normally Councillor Scott is not here today. Anybody like to leave? I would. So I see the comments from the disability access group. I don't know if that is enough to actually recommend refusal on this. It would be nice if they could fit in open access. I can't see with this conversion that is actually planning requirements on this site, and there are many buildings in town that are similar to this. In fact, I actually think it could potentially tidy up the back of this site, which is slightly underutilized. So, with a little terrace, bits in there, it's in the town centre, so there's no need for parking, bikes, things, and they're ticking the box. So I think I'm going to see it in a different kind of reason to recommend fusion on it. So I'm going to do
so much.
Are there any comments?
My only concern is the building is in the garage down by Jake.
Yeah.
I think it's literally by the down the alleyway past the town restaurant.
As somebody who lives in a very small flat in London and you see the flat in some cases less than a third of the size of my flat in London, I just worry about the movement.
You're completely right, and actually, I tried to cross reference this to minimum condition requirements. We also done, and something is known. Well, there are, but through half of the
I just don't know that it's a studio as opposed to that.
No, I think it's very, 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 very valid, and I think maybe that we could. Add to our acceptance to a subject to adhering to minimum space and There is software, which actually I think would be really good when we start to look at the software and market. If you don't think it's important to use to cross-reference plans with AI now into and they can get AI and look at the plan and tell you whether it's compliant. So we really have like this. But are we happy to add that amendment to subject to?
Yeah.
Okay. Another comment on that. Yeah, would you like to answer that?
No, not really. I'm just concerned.
This is DM22 3668, Stoneleigh West, College Lane. It's proposed in single story, three bedroom, with new access and parking for two cars. The plans as have been slightly this is the Okay, there's some of the plans. So this is Ashback.
It would be really good to get the picture of the access where we did things. The proposal was to come in from the Cranston Road down that track, which is probably going to be the same private road. Normally, you can access the bottom of that image, there's a Moles Chambers, which is where the watershed is. That's the road on the side there. And then a little bit further down, if you can just imagine it, there's a road off to the right, which leads into the project. So that's the access point. But I have a problem with this application on several points, really. I don't think that the application is in keeping with the area. I don't know the design of the property and the location. So we've got DP26 and DP3 on that one. There has been historic issues with flooding, again, which is mentioned, which is the energy of DP. But there's also some material considerations which I think need to be taken into account as well. The overbearing site and property for the neighbours, lack of the loss of light and loss of privacy for several neighbours. I don't think it's in keeping with the buildings in that little patch. I would say it's not very well. So those are all my material considerations that I think we need to take into account. That's also the topography. So if you are in any of the properties which are low, it's not the issues with access, overlooking, overbearing, lots of that. The design for others and labeling, so the access.
One thing we do know is the ownership of land, like the land, and the land. So I could apply to if I got it, then we would have.
I do wonder about the habitat loss you mentioned. I wonder if there should be an environmental survey.
I'd just like to say that huge university has probably been moving projects with some issue. Analysis.
Not in my bit there. So I agree with I can all of that. Can I show hands? For the comment you offer your home to the dinner if you wish to. Thank you. BM23052. This is 12 Christopher Road. This is loft conversion with two dormer windows. This is west and east movement place. Two roof lights, removal of south roof lights, removal of chimney to provide bedroom and suite. This is the location of the road there. So this is the current property here. Which I think is correct. empty roof. And here, but I think the new one isn't too bad. I do have an issue with this window here. I see the I'm going to recommend approval on it. Not there's no objections to mention.
I don't like your sense of humor. I think from a design perspective, it's not very good design, and I don't think it's in keeping with the rest of the road. There are those sort of not Tudor style of row of them, and it goes into Victorian semis and terraced. And there are other properties in there which have extensions, but they've not done that. To have those houses are very similar to what they have in Garland. And when houses have been extended to put more rooms in the loft, they've built over the garage bit, which is on the left, which I think is already built into a room already, and made it into a much nicer house. I really don't think it's different enough design. I understand why.
Any other comments? It's not on the plan, I'm not going to discuss it with an MDC. I think it's maybe worth just noting that the MDC I'm sure it is. In that case, guys, thank you very much for a very prompt meeting. I'm very happy. The time of the meeting is 7:29 to close it, and the next meeting is Monday, the 17th of April.